Welcome back to Horse Master with Julie Goodnight.
Well, Dale, a couple of weeks ago when Jennifer was at my clinic, we talked about the horse and her injury, and what I recommended was that she switch to this Myler combination bit. We've got the O4 in his mouth. The mouthpiece is the O4. And I mainly wanted to give her something that would help him lighten up so that she wasn't having to ride with so much contact and so much heaviness in her hands. And what I feel, what Jennifer, he's been in this combination for a couple of weeks now. You've been riding him?
Yeah, 2 weeks.
2 weeks. And he feels incredibly light to me. I'm just barely holding the slightest amount of contact. And feels like he's doing a lot more work to hold himself in the frame rather than me do it. But how does his mouth look, Dale?
Well, his mouth is perfectly quiet right now. You remember on the other bit when she was in here, once in a while he was sticking his tongue in his throat. Right now he is very, very relaxed. His mouth is quiet. He's very light into your hand. So this shows he's relaxed more in his mind.
Yeah.
So in my opinion, you put him in exactly the bit he should be in to learn.
Okay. And it's been feeling pretty good for you in terms of not having so much weight.
Well, yeah. Oh, yeah. It's made a tremendous difference in, you know, my arm. I don't get nearly as tired, and it's just all the way around. I mean, he's more in frame, and he's happier.
Quiet. He's happy. Yeah.
Yeah.
The only problem is we can't take him to the horse show in this bit.
No.
It's not a bit that's accepted by any dressage rule book yet. We hope that'll change in the future. But right now, there are bit restrictions in any rule book that you show. The rules dictate the type of bit you use, and this is not a bit that's acceptable in dressage. But Dale, is it conceivable that she trains in one bit and shows in another?
Absolutely. What we're going to do is we're going to try a legal bit on him, which is the least interfering of a legal bit at the moment. It will not flap and pinch his outer lips and his bars, which is going to be a help to him. So we'll go.
And that the bit that's accepted by the dressage book is?
It's the O2 mouthpiece.
The Myler O2 mouthpiece. And that's on a D-ring?
You can have it on a D-ring, an egg, but a loose ring.
Okay. So what I'd like to do is, we know we're going to want to school him a lot in this bit. You're happy with him. He's happy with it. But what I'd like to do is go try the O2, the mouthpiece that you're going to show in, and let's see how he works in that.
Sounds good to me.
All right.
Me too. Let's try it.
Okay.
Okay.
Jennifer, just leave him on a loose rein for a few minutes while he's getting used to the feel of this new bit in his mouth. And I want you to just gently reverse him, bring him back by us again. And then turn to the left. So you're going to just real gently and slowly and softly turn him to the right, then turn him to the left. Let's just take a few minutes to let him get used to the different feel in his mouth. So what we've got on him now is a Myler O2 mouthpiece on an egg butt side piece. And Dale, this bit is good for her to show dressage in. Is that right?
It's a legal bit, yes.
Good. And so the difference between this bit, the combination, of course, distributes pressure in more places to the nose, the chin, the mouth, the pull. This is going to have more pressure just on the mouth. Is that right?
Yes, because it's went back to putting more tongue pressure on the horse.
Okay. And so far he's staying pretty quiet in the mouth, but you can almost see as she's starting to do more with the reins, he's gonna tense up a little bit. Let's, Jennifer, go ahead and bring him up to light contact and ask him to come into a frame for you. Try to stay real soft in your hands and keep adding leg pressure as you add rein pressure. And then soften your hands as you feel him soften. And whenever you're ready, looks pretty good right now, go ahead and ask him for a trot. And she's gonna have to use this bit when we go to the show ring. I see already his mouth's a little more tense in the mouth than he was in the combination. So how much do you think she needs to train in the combination? Does she need to ride in this bit at home, just at the show? What's her plan?
No, you need to ride. You need to change your bits and do a test every once in a while to let the horse feel the difference, just like you would at a show.
Okay. So she's going to ride, what did you say, 90% of the time in the combination bridle?
Well, we spend 90% of our lives training a horse, and we spend 10% or less showing them. So we want them as relaxed as possible in their mind. And every once in a while, you go back to a legal bit, do a test to show that you can, because your horse is doing more self-carriage now than he is working off the mouth.
Mm-hmm. Now, he's starting to fret with his mouth a little bit now as she's working the reins. But when he softens and she softens the rein, his mouth completely quiets down. I would say he's a lot better in this bit than the original snaffle we had him in. But this is more tongue pressure than he was getting in the combination bridle.
Yes, but he has no pinch on his outer lip and bars with this bit that he did have on the original bit.
Because of the single joint?
Well, the other bit was a three-piece, but this stops.
Oh, that's right. It was a three-piece.
Mm-hmm. So,
yeah, so it doesn't flex all the way in. Jennifer, let's go ahead and have you try a couple of trot to canter to trot transitions. And I'm interested in how well he maintains his frame. That was pretty nice with this bit. Now, does he feel heavy in your hands, Jennifer?
Little.
Not as bad as...
Not as bad as the other one.
Okay. And remember, this is a two-way street. So for him to be light, you have to be light. So try to soften your reins. Keep an alternating rhythm in your hands.
Try.
Say soft and light. And let him come off of the contact. So you're going to, when he lightens up to you, let him find a release. So you're not pulling on him quite so much. Good. Good. Let's bring him back to trot now. He's actually staying quieter in the mouth than I thought he would. And reverse directions. And Jennifer, we'll just go ahead and have you try a couple of canter transitions in this direction. Don't hold him up. Let him hold himself up. Let him find the slack in the reins. In other words, when he lifts his shoulders, that's better, and softens up, you're going to soften the rein contact. Let him find slack when he comes into frame. Shorten your reins just a little bit. Good. Good. And back to trot. Well, I think from here, I'd like to see her, to tell you the truth, work more in the combination bit at this time, since it's new to him to work in a relaxed frame of mind and to be more relaxed in the mouth, and then wait a few weeks and start picking up using this bridle, what, one day a week or something?
Absolutely. You know, here's the thing we've always tried to establish. Is don't be afraid to train in a bit that's illegal if your horse is relaxed in the mind. The legal bit is always not always the kindest bit on a horse. So, but you can go from a bit that keeps them relaxed in the mind where they allow you to continue their education and go to a legal bit and go through a test.
Okay. And of course by legal we just mean accepted by the rule book. In whatever discipline, all these bits are legal,
right.
Of course. So that's great. Well, Jennifer, I think we've done enough experimenting with him today. Let's try him tomorrow again in the combination, and we're going to keep working on this lightness.
Okay, sounds good to me.
All right.
Stay tuned to Horsemaster with Julie Goodnight.